episode 2. So, just gotten halfway through this part, Act 1. And, we've got four characters together. The youngest brother, Pen Pen here. Get him, Pen Pen! And, the mechanic guy who fights naked, and the girl best friend, who has psychic powers and is probably metagame hitting on the player. She blows kisses. She can paralyze you with her psychic powers. Who was that man the Pen Pen just beat up? I don't know. He wore a suit of armor or something and had Freddy Krueger claws or something like that. He may have been an assassin. Good fortune. Do I remember the rice balls? Yes, the second one, so the second spot, and the third is the third. And then the fourth is the first, and the fifth is the second, the sixth is the third, and the first is the third. Yeah, you get the idea. Onigiri! Let's have some. Can serve them. I think I end up using them later on. Chapter 2, well, we'll see if they transfer over. So I'm debating whether I go to that farm with the cows or not. I forget if there's anything good that I want. Decide just to go on. Not worry about it. You can see some Nihilists are blocking the way. Oh, some squirrel training for Pen Pen. And I go with health, okay, button mashing time. Pen Pen is watching you, I don't... Hope you've caught on by now. Send us back. So, yeah. I think you have to get the girl, at least. I don't remember about Pen Pen in the previous part, but it would appear that the way was blocked. So there's many moments where they shoehorn you into certain events, which is good, actually. It's probably how I got so far. It's probably how I was able to beat the game, thanks to the shoehorning, because... otherwise it'd just be running around the map in circles. It's all one big map in this case. So that's kinda cool. Oh, he wanted some clean underpants, but I had none. Only the dirty kind. Alright, once more across the river. Past the mountains, we'll be at the fair, the festival, whatever you want to call it. The big wheel, the Ferris wheel, merry-go-rounds, funhouse, and the dog. Oh, the dog, what, huh, what? Yes. Craziest loop. So many squirrels in that one spot in a row. Got 40, so. Quite happy with that one. Quite surprised. stunned, if you will. I was stunned. And here we go. Ending off chapter one. Yay! Now let's have some fun! And I'm sure our brother will be here soon, too. We're twins. She's got her powers. She knows.
End of chapter one, you did it, yes!
And juggle the onigiri hands. Maybe he's busking, you know? Could be a busker, too. So, the boy meets this dog character. The brother is there, I guess, in that black tank top. He's talking with someone. Nothing that suspicious. But meanwhile, the Nihilists are planning something diabolical. For the most famous and world-renowned of all of the Ninku. Yes, she doesn't hide the fact that she's Ninku. No, it's not a secret. She used it to gain popularity as a famous piano player in a jazz bar.
Oh yeah!
Okay, so meanwhile, these dishes can wait. The Ninku call, I must help my friend. Can sense something is wrong. So the older brother, if you will, Donald, let us go.
But first I will have some of this putrid stew. It's a unique experience.
Continuing on. Now you're down to one character. Kind of like a parallel story part, yes? All the characters you got, you don't use them for now. Just got the older brother. And he is happy. 10. Oh, it's not a lot, really. But it'll do. And I'm realizing now that the rice balls I can serve from the other group have disappeared, so it is parallel. And here's something kind of funny. Sometimes forget this, but only when you're him and solo can you pass through these mountains here. He uses his power of flight, yes. He can fly and has wind stuff. The younger brother has wind. But the third guy, the get naked guy, he uses earth powers. This particularly potent putrid stew. So later on, we have access to the whole map. If you come back here, you actually get blocked by the mountain. You have too many characters. So he's on the way to the big city. That was a small city nonetheless, but... Oh, here it is, yes. But no, he visits some kid. What does the kid say? But it's time for a little fly around. So he must have gotten information. The kid said, "Ah, I saw Nihilists. They're heading to the industrial city. Manufacturing side. They're preparing something big." Yes, there's gangs of these Nihilists all over the place. Basically going to have to fight the first boss. You'll have another character, that piano player I was talking about, and the older brother. And the piano player, well, you get her and then it's the fight. So you don't have any chance to train her, so it's important. I think this is the most important moment in the game, You should grind, you should do as much squirrel training as you can. Because you'll have to fight a couple bosses. Three bosses? Well, one guy has two forms, but basically three boss fights. Three fights with this guy. And depending on your luck, the piano player, the girl, she can get in some good damage, but she can't do it alone. It's designed that way. I pump it all up, man. His belly is full. See, I mean, they're holding on to giant dice. Giant rats, bears, claw armor guys. There's just something, you know, post-apocalyptic. But what is the cause? What is the source? We'll look at that in the next episode, I guess. We'll stop here, and there'll be some intense training in the city, and then boss fights. I'll see you for that next time.